Did your Goodman gas furnace stop firing up this season? If so, you're in the right place. A few nights ago, like many other homeowners, we fired up our gas heater for the first time this season. Our heater worked for a day, but then a couple nights later, we noticed that the heater was not coming on despite the fact that it was actually getting very cold in our house. So I went and checked the situation further by going to the thermostat. After playing with the thermostat, I quickly realized the heater was not coming on and it was not a thermostat issue. It was at this point I realized I would have to crawl up into the attic and take a closer look at the gas furnace. Our furnace is in the attic, so I had to pull the attic door down and trudge upstairs. This is our HVAC setup to give you a big picture view of what I'm working on before I dig inside. A quick disclaimer, I am not an HVAC technician, nor am I qualified to give expert advice on HVAC systems. What I'm sharing here is strictly for informational purposes only. If you are not comfortable working on your own system, you should call a local professional HVAC expert to diagnose and work on your system. I've removed the top panel. I've removed the bottom panel. This is the panel which leans on the furnace switch. What I'm doing here is attempting to diagnose the furnace by watching and listening to the furnace while my finger is on the furnace switch. I'm looking for the igniter to light up and fire up the burners. However, all I'm seeing and hearing is the motor running. I let it run for a couple of minutes before I decide to look at the circuit board. As you can see, there is a bunch of wires going in and out of the circuit board. But what I'm looking for is the diagnostic light. I'm looking for clues to figure out why my furnace is not firing up. I see the light is blinking. However, I'm carefully watching and recording the blinking light pattern to make sure I interpret it correctly. You can see the light is blinking 3 times each cycle. I then look for the installer's chart behind one of the panels I removed. When I zoom in, I can see that 3 blinking lights means pressure switch stuck open. That night I emailed my friend Justin, who's in the HVAC business, my Google Photos and videos to give him a better view of what was going on. He's pretty good at diagnosing these situations remotely with the proper videos and photos. That night I also did a few Google searches. I wanted to know what pressure switch stuck open meant, and I got a lot of results. But seeing that it was getting late, I decided to let it go for the night. The next morning, my friend Justin text messages me his assessment. He thinks I might have a clog, or I might have a leak in the hose. He suggests I get a paper clip and poke it in the hose connections to clear any obstruction. As a safety measure, I first turn the gas valve off. Then I carefully remove the hose. The hose feels flimsy, so I don't want to accidentally damage it. Then I insert the paperclip to clear any obstructions. If you look closely, you will see that the 2 nozzle connections have very small holes. So it isn't hard to imagine a small piece of debris clogging them up. Because my first video clip was a bit unsteady, I reenacted what I did earlier. This time I mounted my phone on a tripod to give you a steadier view and better perspective where in the furnace I'm working. I blow out the hose a few times just in case there was any debris in there. I reattach the hose. I also make sure they are secure. Again, be careful handling the hose. It feels flimsy and you don't want to accidentally damage it. I turn the gas valve back on. Then I press the furnace switch to see if what I did worked. I am happy to report that the furnace fires up correctly the first time. You can see the igniter glow and start getting hotter before all the burners fire up. I let it run for a few seconds more to make sure it continues to burn. Then, I finish up by putting the two front panels back on. I place the bottom panel on first, then I place the top panel last. I hope you liked this video. If you did, do me a favor and hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. You will receive notifications when I upload new videos. Let me know your experiences with Goodman furnaces and how you were able to fix your furnace. I'd really like to hear from you. And I will see you in my next video.